Thank you very much. Another Christmas is almost here, and like most people, I'm doing my last-minute shopping. Let me see. For my wife, I think I'll buy her a nice, brand-new 1975 putter. To make sure she knows it's for me, I'm putting my initials on it. Oh, grandchildren. Oh, yes, a lot of grandchildren. We got Terrence and Coley, and we have Peter and David, Melanie, Ronnie, Wendy, Paige. Loaded. And you know they get a lot of stuff from grandparents, but I'm going to buy them something special. Everybody always kind of forgets. Batteries. They don't call me foxy old grandpa for nothing.
Excuse me. I'm Perry Mason, the star detective.
What can I do for you, Mr. Mason?
You may call me Perry. Perry.
All right, what can I do for you, Perry? Perry.
Isn't it true that a few moments ago you were seen walking through this department store singing Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas? Yes. And isn't it true, and I put it to you, that you're often guilty of such unsolicited singing and in point of fact will sing your silly, stupid songs anywhere you can?
Just a minute.
Where were you on the night of April 21st?
Probably asleep.
Ladies and gentlemen of the department store, I submit that on that evening you were in a gas station on Route 66 and were singing to the mechanic on duty, Have Yourself a Merry Little April the 22nd. That's ridiculous. It's not. Did anyone ever tell you that you're eyes have little flecks of gold when you're angry? Cabby!
Hey, sir, is that Raymond Burr?
As sure as you're rich little. Yeah, that assembly is stealing your whole act.
Yeah, well, what's he doing as the store detective?
Oh, inflation, Rich, inflation. A lot of stars are working over Christmas holidays. Jack Benny, Howard Cosell, Johnny Carson.
Hey, that's exciting. I'm going to see some of those people.
No, Rich, you're going to be some of those people.
Okay, pal. Give me a little traveling music. And away we go!
Welcome to the Perry Como Christmas Show. Starring Peggy Fleming. Special attraction, Rich Little and his friend. Special guest stars, the Carpenters. And special feature, the story of the first Christmas. Brought to you and your family by General Telephone and Electronics. GTE, a growing concern for your growing needs.
All right. shoppers, this is Howard Cosell. Today's special is cut-rate golf balls on the second floor.
Pardon me, I'd like to buy a pair of skates.
Just who do you think you are?
I'm Peggy Fleming.
So you're Peggy Fleming, and still you want to buy a pair of skates. Regardless of the fact that since you were 3 times world skating champion, star of countless TV specials, Olympic gold medal winner, and up until a few weeks ago, your own concert on ice, you haven't had one single solitary triumph.
I'm sorry, Howard. I realize now that I'm exactly like you. Just another pretty face.
At least the kid is honest.
Is this clown bothering you, Peg?
Yes, every Monday night.
I take it back. Well, 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 if it isn't Perry Como. First a soubrette on skates, and now a singer on the skits.
How can we get rid of him, Perry?
Watch. Look, Howard, somebody's returning your book.
What? Why, of all the flagrant profligacy.
Only his hairdresser knows for sure. I hope he didn't make you lose your Christmas spirit, Peg.
Oh, nothing can do that.
Good. It's that time of year when the world falls in love. Every song you hear seems to say, Merry Christmas. May your every wish come true. It could happen to you.
Thank you.
Peg, you're definitely a good skater.
Thank you very much. But, gee, it's getting late. I better get my skates.
Yes, and I gotta go get that putter for my wife, too. Was Howard the only salesman around here?
Here's Johnny! Ah, what are you two people looking for? Let's make a deal. Perry, how would you like to buy one of my Johnny Carson suits? My company has just been named fashion consultant to Chico and the Man. By the way, I just heard that ABC has just come up with the perfect answer to that show. It's called Harpo and the Sissy. May the NBC peacock stick his beak in your CBS eye.
Are you going to let him talk to you that way, Perry?
Certainly not. This is a job for GTE.
GTE? What does that mean?
Well, it means at Christmas time, GTE means greetings to everybody. But in my contract, it means general telephone and electronics.
Oh.
We'll be right back, folks. Harpo and the Sissy.
Hey!
You. I danced to one of your records on my first date. I just can't think of your name.
Perry Como.
Perry Como! Oh, my goodness. Are you still alive?
I admit it's hard to tell sometimes, but I think so.
Oh, he's just as funny off as he is on.
Yeah, just the last of the great clowns. That's me.
Oh, I wish Archie could have been here. We could talk about old times. And you could talk about the first Christmas like you used to on TV. A real eyewitness report.
A little before my time.
Oh, you show business people so sensitive about your age.
No, not me. I'm still going like 60.
No kidding! 60. What happened to the good old days?
I didn't take them.
Well, I sure do miss them. Boy, the way Glenn Miller played. Not so loud. Songs that made the hit parade. Guys like me, we had it made. Those were the days. And you knew who you were then. Girls were girls and men were men. Mister, we could use a man like Herbert Hoover again. That's for sure. Oh, Mr. Como, would you sign this card for Archie?
I will.
Oh, wonderful. Isn't it lovely? It's just like you and Archie, old-fashioned.
About the little king, it's time to don our gayest apparel. It's the Yuletide thing. We bring a friend or welcome a stranger, win him a stay, cheer him on his way, and celebrate the child in the manger born on Christmas Day.
I'm beginning to sound a lot like Perry. So relaxed and cool. Sorry. My impression would be complete. It would be really neat to fall asleep while sitting on his stool.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door.
A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is a wish of Barney and Ben.
Dowsable talking, we'll go for a walk, is the hope of Janice and Jen.
And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start. And the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing right within.
Sets the theme, helps me dream my Christmas dream. Every year I dream it, hoping things will change. An end to the crying, the shouting, the dying. And I hope you will dream it too. It's Christmas, remember, we've got to remember. So light the light, I'm home tonight. I need you to warm me, to calm me, to love me, to help me to dream my Christmas dream.
silver bells all seem to say, throw cares away, Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, big and the bold.
See what I can do.
Hi, Santa.
Oh, hello, little boy. Ho, ho, ho. It's Santa Jack. The original old blue eyes is back.
Well, I never thought I'd see Jack Benny as Santa Claus. Never.
Well, I'm a change man, Perry. Ever since the president told the whole country to be cheap. Imagine. After all these years, misers are where it's at.
You're really fighting inflation, huh, Jack?
Well, it's given me a whole new mortgage on life. And with the shortage of pennies, I've even started pinching girls again. Now, you won't believe this, Perry. Now, try to keep a straight face. You won't believe this, Perry. But on... Now, cut that. But on Christmas Eve, I'm giving a bottle of perfume to every girl in the store.
Oh, that's unbelievable, Jack. You realize how many girls there are in the store?
Well, what's the difference? They'll still have to share the one bottle.
I can. Richard?
Well, gosh, if it isn't the Carpenter. Perry... They've got the cutest new record out, and it's all about me. Why don't you go and sing it, kids?
Anything for you, Santa.
Okay.
Guys, they're cute,
okay,
aren't they?
You really enjoy being Santa Claus, don't you, Jack?
I love it. And you know, I can hardly wait on Christmas Eve to come down the chimney and wake up all those little kids and see if they want to buy some toys.
Buy some toys?
That's right. Buy some toys.
You better not cry, you better not pout, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list, checking it twice, gonna find out who. Claus is coming to town.
The day that you were born, the angels got together
and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkled moonlight in her hair, a golden starlight in her eyes of blue.
It's impossible, tell the sun to leave the sky, it's just impossible. It's impossible, ask a baby not to cry, it's just impossible. And tomorrow, should you ask me for the world, somehow I'd get it. I would sell my very soul and not regret it. For to live without your love is just impossible.
Sharing horizons, let her move us. Watching the signs along the way. Talking it over, just the two of us. Working together day to day. Together. And when the evening comes, we smile. So much of life ahead. We'll find a place where there's room to grow. And yes, we've just begun. We've only just begun. But I don't let feeling get me down. Now that you're around me.
Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Don't let the moon break your heart. Love blooms at night, in daylight it dies. Don't let the stars get in your eyes. Oh, keep your heart from me, for someday I'll return. And you know you're the only one I'll ever love.
He'll ever love.
I'll ever love.
Every sha-la-la-la, every woe still shines. Every sing-a-ling-a-ling that you're starting to sing so fine. All my best memories come back clearly to me. Some can't even make me cry, just like before. It's yesterday once more.
Till the end of time.
It's yesterday once more.
No other love have I.
We've only just begun.
In the excitement of buying gifts and decorating trees, sometimes we're apt to forget the true meaning of Christmas. So I'd like to tell you a story that the whole world has heard now for 2,000 years. But it's one that we always love to hear over and over again because of what it says and because it's true. This story began in the days of Caesar Augustus, the Emperor of Rome.
Caesar had proclaimed that all the people in his far-flung empire should come forward and be counted. Among them, there came a man and a woman. His name was Joseph, and her name was Mary.
Weary, weary travelers, far away from home, on the road to Bethlehem, to heed the call from Rome.
Joseph and Mary had come a long way from Nazareth. The journey was tiring, for they had endured countless hardships as they traveled the many miles through strange towns and desolate lands. But it was destined that something very special would come to pass in this town this very night. For this was the little town Bethlehem.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark streets shines the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight.
It was getting dark when Joseph and Mary arrived in Bethlehem. All the rooms at the inn were taken, so they spent the night at the stable. This night, something special did happen. A baby boy was born unto Mary, and they called him Jesus. They had no crib for the baby, so Mary put little Jesus to sleep in the soft, sweet hay of a manger. Jesus lay asleep in the manger. The shepherds on the hillside near Bethlehem were tending their flock.
The first Noel the angels did say was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where on a cold winter's night that was so deep.
Suddenly, a great light shone in the sky. The shepherds were frightened. Even the animals were hushed and still. But then they heard the voice of an angel of the Lord, and they no longer were frightened. For the angel brought good tidings. News of a Savior born this day. News of Christ the Lord.
Joyful all ye nations, rise. Join the triumph of the skies. With the angelic host proclaim, Christ is born.
The The angels told the shepherds they would find the Christ child lying in the manger. The shepherds hurried to find the child, and when they did, they fell on their knees to worship him, for he was Christ the Lord.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come. Bethlehem, come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore.
Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
And all through the night, a bright new star shone in the heavens. Far away, three men saw that shining star, and they used it as a guide to lead them to the Christ child. Who were these three men who followed the star?
We three kings of Orient are, bearing gifts we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Star of might, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
The new star guides them straight to Bethlehem, to a little baby lying in the manger. There the three wise men present gifts to the Christ child. The first Christmas gifts ever given to anyone. A gift of gold, of frankincense, and of myrrh. And they too fall on their knees to worship him. And now a great peace settles on the night, for it is a holy night.
Silent night, oh. All is calm, all is bright. Round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep.
This is why when we celebrate Christmas, we think of Bethlehem. We think of the Virgin Mary. We think of the three wise men and the birth of the Christ child, the first Christmas.
Thank you.
From all of us to all of you, a very Merry Christmas. Good night.
Harry Como's Christmas Show has been presented by General Telephone and Electronics, who wish you and your family a joyous holiday season.